I can hear chatter going on already. I just want to start this morning by telling you my latest, quote, wedding story. So I got a text on Thursday evening about 9:30, and the wedding's next Saturday. And Noelle said, guess what happened? Mitchell was cutting, wanted an apple. So, and he's an Eagle Scout, by the way. And he was cutting up the apple, and he sliced his finger. So they went to the emergency room, and he got stitches in his finger, his ring finger. And so they said, come back in 7 to 10 days, we'll take the stitches out. And he said, I'll be on my honeymoon. They said, when are you getting married? Next Saturday. Okay, come in just before that, and we'll take him out. So we have no idea if he's actually going to be able to put the ring on or not. But is that not funny? It's typical layman. Welcome to Prospect Church, United Methodist Church. No, yes, that's right. Prospect Street, United Methodist Church. I don't even know where I am. Why don't you stand and greet each other in the name of the Lord? Just a reminder, if you ordered ham loaves, pick them up after the service today in the kitchen. Ham loaves in the kitchen after the service. Let's stand and praise the Lord together. Thank you for being up.
My life is in you, Lord. My strength is in you, Lord. My hope is in you, Lord. In you, it's in you. My life is in you, Lord. My strength is in you, Lord. My hope is in you, Lord. In you, it's in you. I will praise you with all of my life. I will praise you with all of my strength, with all of my life, with all of my strength. All of my hope is in you. My life is in you, Lord. My strength is in you, Lord. My hope is in you, Lord. In you, it's in you. My life is in you, Lord. My strength is in you, Lord. My help is in you, Lord. In you, it's in you, in you.
Amen.
While we are between songs, I would like to take this opportunity to invite you to stay over for Sunday school and then for the second service, because the song that the choir is singing today is a foretaste of heaven, and I don't want you to miss it. Thank you.
Huh? Yeah.
Let there be praise, let there be joy in our hearts. Sing to the Lord, give him the glory. Let there be praise, let there be joy in there be joy in our hearts. Sing to the Lord, give him the glory. Let there be praise, let there be joy in our hearts. Forevermore, let his love fill the air, and let there be praise.
There be praise,
let there be joy in our hearts. Sing to the Lord, give him the glory. Let there be praise, let there be joy in our hearts. Forevermore, let his love fill the air, and let there be praise.
Amen. You may be seated. I'll let you get back. Happy Mother's Day. Not only to all you mothers out there, but also to all women. All of us, every single one of us, have a mother. Not all of us are mothers. Sometimes, as mothers, we may wish we weren't mothers, right, ladies? I mean, that's the truth. Thank you, Jerry. But our mothers helped us be who we are today. And if your mother is not living right now, but living in heaven, would she be proud of everything you do? It's a good thing to think about, isn't it? But happy Mother's Day. And now, oh, Lillian's getting it. I have a video for you. Yeah, you won't want to miss this one.
Warning. Use of this product may alter your perception of reality. Everything looks the same.
Guys, can somebody hit me with some juice? And listen, pulp, no pulp, doesn't make a difference to me. You're the ones dealing with the diaper.
Mom goggles.
Have fun glamping.
What is that?
Have no idea. We got this.
Yep. I mean, think about this. The kids are older. Now they practically take care of themselves.
Nobody understands me.
We're doomed.
What did we do the last time they left us alone with the kids?
Mom goggles! Those things were so great. I mean, they helped us see things like moms see things. Whatever happened to them?
I definitely put them in a place I knew I would never forget.
Great. Where are they?
I forgot.
Computer phone, order 2 pair of mom goggles.
Ordering 2 pairs of mom joggers.
Nope. No. Goggles. Mom goggles.
You'll always be my baby.
You're so weird.
No, no, no.
Hi, guys.
Just leave me alone.
You come back here and say that to my face, young lady.
I'm so confused on how I'm feeling. I don't even know why I'm angry, but it feels good to yell.
What you're feeling is natural. You truly are a gift from God, and I hope you know I'm always here for you.
You're the best dad in the world. I'm sorry I don't tell you that more often.
I am gonna cry like a man child at your wedding.
Stop looking at me!
Laundry. Look at this mess. It is literally a pigsty in here, mister. How are you gonna organize your life if you can't organize your sock drawer? First, it's unmatched socks. Then, unfinished homework. Then, kicked out of school. Next, jail. How does she process this every day?
All right, one more time. Plastic bowls up top, face down, forks up, knives down, plates in the center, pots and pans we wash by hand. Now repeat it back to me.
No, I don't think the joggers make you look fat.
I've got my dad's thighs.
Don't you need the goggles?
No. I've seen your mom do this so many times. You have a great mom, you know that.
That's great. Mm. Can you hand me the barf bucket?
No, okay, here we go.
I got your cat out of the dryer. You're welcome.
I don't own a cat.
How do they do it?
Cats?
Moms. How do they do all of this without the goggles?
They don't need them. Moms have this God-given ability.
Yeah, it's like no matter what the circumstance, they always see the best version of what their kids can be.
Moms are a little glimpse of heaven.
It wasn't me!
Us to pray for the Lee Wing family. They lost a son this week. Look at your prayer lists. There's many people who are still hurting. Ken Ryder is doing extremely well after his major surgery. He will be back in church soon. So let us just remember him though. Also, remember, if you would, my family traveling on Tuesday, they won't get here to Thursday. They decided they needed 2 days in Chicago. Why? I don't know why. But anyway, they're spending 2 days in Chicago, and then the parsonage will be busy place. Pray for that everything just goes smoothly and peacefully, that everybody can love each other at the wedding. You know exactly what I mean, right? Let's go to the Lord in prayer this morning. Oh Lord, our God, we come before your throne. Lord, let us know what it is to be humble, like you were. For in humility, we find true love. Lord, we lift up to you this family who has lost a loved one. We'll remember all mothers today. And I pray for fond memories for those whose mothers have passed on, but they can still think about them today. Lord, our world is a crazy place. People don't know how to get along with each other, and love is not a word that people really recognize. Too flippantly, people say, "I love you," when what they really mean is something totally different. You showed us how to love. And as we continue trying to figure out how to be church, to be your church, help us discern with the gift of the Holy Spirit so we can do your work here in this church and around the world. And now, Lord, we lift up to you the prayer that you taught us as we say together, "Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen."
Believe in God, and we all need Jesus, cause life is hard, and it might not get
If you are able, please stand for the reading of the scripture today, which comes from the book of Acts, chapter 1, verses 3 through 11. After Jesus suffered, he showed himself to these men and gave many convincing proofs that he was alive. He appeared to them over a period of 40 days and spoke about the kingdom of God. On one occasion, while he was eating with them, he gave them this command: Do not leave Jerusalem, but wait for the gift my Father promised, which you have heard me speak about. For John baptized with water, but in a few days you will be baptized with the Holy Spirit. So when they met together, they asked him, Lord, are you at this time going to restore the kingdom to Israel? He said to them, it is not for you to know the times or dates the Father has set by his own authority, but you will receive power when the Holy Spirit comes on you. And you will be my witnesses in Jerusalem and in all Judea and Samaria and to the ends of the earth. After he said this, he was taken up before their very eyes, and a cloud hid him from their sight. They were looking intently up into the sky as he was going, when suddenly two men dressed in white stood beside them. Men of Galilee, they said, why do you stand here looking into the sky? This same Jesus who has been taken from you into heaven will come back in the same way you have seen him go into heaven. This is the word of God from long ago for the people of God today. Thanks be to God. You may be seated. Let us pray. O Lord, as we gather today, we feel your presence. And we ask you to open our eyes and our ears, our hearts and our souls, so we can truly hear your word as you speak to us. In your wonderful name we pray. Amen. Can you believe we're on chapter 6 of Believe already? Time does not stand still. The first five beliefs that we have been talking about, there's been nothing new, just covering our basics, because the next part two, the next 10 weeks, which won't be till after the summer, we're going to dig a little deeper, and then the last 10 weeks is going to hit us even harder. But the first five beliefs have been about our relationship with God. Starting today, these next five beliefs are all about our relationship with other people. And it's hard, isn't it? Let's read our key idea today. I believe the church is God's primary way to accomplish his purpose on earth. Okay, I think people were sleeping during the first part of that. So let's say it again. I believe the church is God's primary way to accomplish his purpose on earth. Let those words just sink in. We don't just show up on Sunday mornings. We are to carry out God's purpose every single day. So let's read our key verse in Ephesians. Sorry, Lillian. Together. Speaking the truth in love, we will grow to become in every respect the mature body of him who is the head, that is Christ. So let's recap right now the summary of the last 5 weeks. God created humans as his pinnacle of creation. Isn't that amazing? We are God's greatest creation. Do you act like that? I don't even have to go back over the last week, just even yesterday. There were times I did not act like I was truly God's creation. God said that we were very good. And all God ever wanted was a relationship with us and for us to have relationship with each other. sometimes just one goal in life is hard to achieve. And when we put other goals, worldly goals, out there in front of us, we can easily miss this one goal that God had. God's plan of salvation didn't just start when Jesus came to earth. It started at the beginning of time. The whole of the Old Testament was the setup to the coming of God's Son, Jesus. And salvation was completed when Jesus died, rose, and ascended into heaven. That's what we're going to look at today. We're going to look at the words you just heard in Scripture, which are Jesus' parting words to his disciples, not only those who were present then, but us today. Did you know that there was a huge religious holiday celebrated on Thursday this week? Did you join in? And you're all saying, okay, Pastor, you really lost it. We have no idea what you're talking about. Does anybody know what Thursday was? It was Ascension Day. The church does an extremely bad job of celebrating Ascension. 40 days, count them, you have to count Easter as well. 40 days after Easter. As luck would have it, it's the story of the birth of Christ. Now, you're going to tell me, but I thought that that was at Pentecost, which, by the way, is next Sunday. But no. The plan started at Ascension. Let's take a look in a bit more detail at today's scripture to understand why that is the birth, that is the beginning of the birth of the church. Luke, as you know, because you remember this, wrote not only the Gospel of Luke, but also the book of Acts, and it was all written as one. At the end of Luke, the Gospel of Luke, Luke indicates or tells us about the ascension, that Jesus rose up, and then he starts the book of Acts by reiterating that. When there's anything said twice in the Bible, we're supposed to pay attention, real attention. We know that in those 40 days between Easter and when Jesus rose into heaven, there were many witnesses that he appeared to. Not just the 11 disciples, but his brother, and many, many people all around Jerusalem in the surrounding area. Why did he do that? So there would be many witnesses. Not all of them wrote books that are in our Bible, but there were many, many witnesses. The stories are in there so that no one could deny that they had seen Jesus. It was so that they could give witness, write it in the New Testament, and that we would believe today. Jesus, right before he left, his parting words were, "Do not leave Jerusalem, but wait for the Father's gift, the Holy Spirit." How many of you like to wait? Okay, you don't have to put your hands up because every single one of you do, right? We don't like to wait. If we have to pull forward at a fast food drive-through because we have to wait for our food, we're stamping our foot and saying, come on, come on, I'm in a hurry, right? But Jesus said, wait. And many times in our spiritual lives, we pray and expect an immediate answer. We're not willing to wait, to just be with God. Nor did the disciples. They didn't get it because their immediate response was, oh, so is now the time that Israel is to become a powerful nation once more? You see, it was all about themselves. So when you think about yourself and you're very selfish, like me, the disciples did it too. They missed the point that Jesus was saying, because what he was saying was basically, don't worry about the time or the date. Leave that to God. Let God do God's work. But here's the important thing. You will receive the gift that I've been talking about. And that gift will give you power to enable you to be witnesses of all you have seen. In other words, to go and spread the good news. Here in Jerusalem and the surrounding areas. And then, Jesus said, all the ends of the earth. That, my friends, is the task of the church. The Holy Spirit did not enter the disciples until 10 days later. But Jesus planted the seeds on Ascension Day. And he departed from the earth. The birth of the church was very similar to the birth of Jesus Christ. Let's look at that. Do you remember the angel Gabriel? It's going all the way back to Christmas. The angel Gabriel told Mary that she was going to bear a son. And Mary's response was, well, how is that possible? I'm a virgin. And the angel said these words, the Holy Spirit will come upon you, and the power of the Most High will overshadow you. Almost the same words that Jesus spoke to his disciples. Now, Mary didn't have the baby the next day. She had to wait 9 whole months, right? Think about that on Mother's Day. I'm glad all that stuff's over and done with. There had to be a preparation time, a time of waiting and being with God. So the ascension was the beginning of a time of waiting until this promise happened. And the waiting period is extremely important. It's when God prepares those he has called and those to whom they will witness so that they are ready to hear. Mary went to see Elizabeth, someone with whom she could share and discuss everything that was going on with her. The disciples gathered together in one place so they could talk and discuss as they waited for God's gift to appear. But this time, as they gathered in the upper room, their meeting place, it wasn't just the 11, it was other people as well. The women, including his mother, and I'm sure his brothers were there too. While they were waiting, it doesn't mean they were inactive. We're waiting to see what the Holy Spirit is going to show us as church, as we know it today, is changing, because it is changing. God is doing a new work on the earth, and we must be patient and we must wait on the Holy Spirit. The disciples stayed together in the upper room so they could support one another. And here's what they did in that meantime. They prayed. They studied what scriptures they had. They discussed everything that Jesus had said, and they began to remember. And in the course of their studies, they realized that the Old Testament actually told them they needed to replace Judas. So they selected 2 people, Joseph and Matthias. And they prayed about it, and God pointed to Matthias. We don't talk about him, but he officially became one of the apostles that day. The background work was being done so that the church could be born with a big bang at Pentecost. And if the ascension and those 10 days hadn't happened, Pentecost would have been a failure. Think about that. They would not have been ready to receive and act on the Holy Spirit. So let's go back to the scripture. After Jesus said those words, he was taken up into heaven in a cloud. Not only in the scripture, but also in the creed, the Apostles' Creed that we say. If you look at that, heaven does not have a capital letter. It's not supposed to be a certain place. It literally means that Jesus was taken up into the air. The point that Luke is making is that Jesus once again has gone, has been taken away from the disciples, this time for a long time. He was reunited with the Father. But unlike when he disappeared before Easter and they ran away scared, the disciples are now wiser, their faith has grown, and they believe. They knew that Jesus was always going to be with them. But now it was in a different form. They were waiting for the gift of the Holy Spirit to come. And then waiting until Jesus returned, because they believed that like we believe it today. We tend to miss what actually happened when Jesus rose up into heaven. The word heaven isn't the important thing. It's the cloud in which he disappeared. This cloud is really important. Think about it. You remember when the Israelites came out of Egypt? Thousands of them. What guided them? God in the form of a pillar of cloud. It showed them the way, but it also went behind them and protected them when the Egyptian army came after them. And then when Moses ascended Mount Sinai to get the Ten Commandments, a cloud came over the mountain. Everyone there could see the cloud, and they knew that that was the presence of God. And Moses disappeared into it. Now think about this. The people were in tents right there at the base of the mountain. They could see the cloud. And yet they sinned anyway. They turned away from God and made a golden calf. And God was right there in their presence. Times have not changed, have they, for humans? Jesus took Peter, James, and John up on a mountain, and there he was transfigured. He was transformed. He was changed. And as soon as that happened, and Moses and Elijah showed up, a cloud came around all of them. And Peter, James, and John collapsed because they didn't know what to say. And they heard the voice of God. The cloud that hid Jesus from the disciples' sight as he ascended was the presence of God to whom he was returning. And all those people saw it. We are amongst today's disciples who are waiting and longing to see Jesus come back in that same cloud as God offers him back to us. And this time he will come to stay, because he will bring the whole army of heaven with him as it comes down to earth. And there will be a new heaven and a new earth. God is restoring everything he has created. Just as angels appeared to the women at the empty tomb, so angels appeared to the disciples that reminded them Jesus will return, but it'll be in God's time. You need to go and wait and prepare for the coming of the gift. Ascension is a time to celebrate the expected gift promised to all those who believe in Jesus. A gift that empowers us to be witnesses and to continue the work of the church. It's the Holy Spirit and the work of the church is it's God's primary tool for accomplishing God's purposes on earth. We do great mission, great outreach. But sometimes I feel when we do fundraisers, and there's nothing wrong with fundraisers, we have to keep this church going. But sometimes people will help out more with those than they will on their knees praying. Certain things in the church people pour their time into are those same people praying for and longing for the gift of the Holy Spirit to become really active in them. It's worth thinking about, isn't it? So here is what church is about. It's about praying. It's about studying Scripture. It's about taking action on God's Word. It's about celebrating the sacraments together. It's about being in fellowship with one another and then inviting others to be with us who want to be a part of this family of God. And it's about ministering to the poor, the outcast, the oppressed, those who do not yet know the love of God. So in what ways can we continue to be the church in the midst of a world that has turned away from God, in the midst of uncertainty, and in the midst of anxiety? How can we be the church that Jesus told the disciples we need to be? The answer to that is found in our key verse. Speak truth in love and grow in the way of Christ. Be more devoted in our prayer time and wait for the discernment of the Holy Spirit to speak. Let's pray. Lord, you said where two or three are gathered together, you are in their midst. Lord, help us as we are in this waiting time to see what the Holy Spirit is going to tell us to be and to do. Help us not be so close-minded that we want to keep everything exactly the same. But help us, Lord, find new ways, fresh ways, of expressing your love to those outside these four walls. And we ask that the Holy Spirit become active in our church and lead us in marvelous ways. In your name we pray. Amen. Let us stand for our closing song.
You are awesome in this place, mighty God. You are awesome in this place.
Oh, Lord our God, as we go forth from this place, let the words we've heard today stay in our mind and bother us. Let our hearts and souls be stirred by the Holy Spirit, and let us wait in eager anticipation for what you are telling us to do. Let our church come even more alive, Lord. In your name we pray. Amen.